This is the State of the City address for the City of Springboro. It's my pleasure to welcome you to this address. I'm going to take my mask off. We are doing adhering to all COVID-19 restrictions, but there's nobody around me right now, so I'm free to do this. I want to share this with you like I do each and every year, but this is a little special this year because of the pandemic. So anyway, my comments will reflect that. As mayor of the City of Springboro, I want to begin my State of the City address by commenting on how uniquely challenging this past year has been for all of us. As individuals, as a community, as a nation, COVID-19 continues to be a threat to our health, safety, and welfare. But I remain optimistic thanks to efforts made by our hardworking and resilient City Council and staff members to respond to this pandemic and the great citizens of our community for coming together to support one another. Although we are 6 feet apart, it is obvious we are closer than ever. COVID dominates 2020. None of us could have imagined the impact COVID-19 would have on our families, businesses, schools, hospitals, elderly care facilities, and so much more. We were faced with loss of employment, preparing our children to safely attend school to learn from home, businesses struggling to keep the doors open with COVID restrictions in place, and simply trying to find ways to stay connected and continue to function. We have learned to protect ourselves by physically distancing and wearing masks to slow the spread of a virus in our country and communities, and that we have mourned the loss of too many lives taken by this pandemic. Our community's efforts to follow the state's orders and guidelines have taken all the precautionary measures to fight COVID-19 have been extraordinary. We are proud of the ways we as community leaders have supported our residents and businesses and are inspired by the many selfless, compassionate gestures made by friends, neighbors, volunteer groups, and the frontline workers in healthcare, education, emergency, safety, and public services who put the safety and needs of our community before their own. Your city staff continue to provide a high level of service to the community while looking for every possible way to support and keep our community healthy through this pandemic. This was achieved through community partnerships and understanding the importance of working together to assess community needs. This past year obviously presented challenges for our businesses, including state restrictions that could dramatically affect their income. At the onset of the pandemic, the city, in partnership with the Springboro Chamber of Commerce, immediately set up a small business stimulus program to help local businesses stay afloat. In total, $106,000 was granted to 38 Springboro businesses to help them continue to operate. In addition, city workers helped the Springboro Community Assistance Center with food transportation and assisted hundreds of residents with free yard waste, recyclables, and bulk item drop-off at the city building when those pickups were suspended due to COVID-19. The city coordinated with local churches and the Springboro Community Assistance Center to create a community resource list for outreach, food, and errands for residents in need, and post a resource list on our website and social media of restaurants offering carryout and grocery store hours and restrictions. We also teamed up with Warren County Community Services and United Way of Warren County to distribute senior citizen care packages. Additionally, we extended the city's tax filing deadline and made virtual tax appointments available for taxpayers needing assistance and additional time to file. CARES Act funding helped us address needs created by the pandemic, specifically in the areas of economic assistance, public safety, PPE, and tech equipment, and we decided it would be imperative to share the monies within the Springboro community. During the September 3rd council meeting, the city presented a check to Springboro City Schools for $100,000 of these eligible funds to upgrade technology in schools and provide Chromebooks and other supplies to students to help facilitate remote learning to comply with COVID-19 precautions. The city also continued to support local businesses by creating an employer grant program to help mid to large size businesses coping with their ability to retain employees or even those that may have had to increase their workforce to respond to demands created by COVID-19. Through this program, 10 businesses received a total of $170,000 in grant monies to help offset the economic impact of the pandemic. We are encouraged by how we, as a community, have come together, and we feel fortunate to be able to support the community in meaningful ways throughout this pandemic. Living in Springboro. One thing I can never say enough is that Springboro is one of the best cities in Ohio to live, work, play, and raise a family. Our city continues to be highly rated in all aspects of community life, including great neighborhoods and schools, and exceptional safety, services, and amenities that now include a Splice Park and a Performing Arts Center. In fact, Springboro was named 2020's fifth best place to raise a family in Ohio, according to a study by the leading personal finance web outlet, WalletHub. The study compared that more than 180 cities using key indicators of ideal family conditions like family and fun, education, health and safety, affordability, and social economics. Once again, Springboro was identified as one of the most family-friendly places in Ohio, scoring strongly across those quality of life factors. It is also important to us to measure Springboro's success on a local level. Since 2008, the city has conducted a citizen satisfaction survey every 3 years with the help of Miami University's Center for Public Management and Regional Affairs. Last year's survey invited approximately 1,000 randomly selected households to rate their level of satisfaction as a resident of Springboro with city services and quality of life aspects in our community. Even though the survey was curbed by the onset of COVID-19, the response rate of 35% was slightly higher than 2017, with residents from 342 households responding to the survey. The city's overall satisfaction rating from the 2020 survey is equal to or better than the findings in 2017 and indicated that 97% of the residents surveyed were satisfied and their greater percentage were very satisfied living in Springboro. What an accomplishment for all of us. Satisfaction levels are consistently high regardless of the length of residency, and half of the survey respondents think Springboro has become a better place to live in the past 5 years. Characteristics such as small town feel, community spirit, appealing neighborhoods, and safety contributed to high ratings with satisfaction levels increasing in areas of public safety, parks, and street maintenance. This is historically the center's highest rating for community surveyed, and we thank you for the vote of confidence. In finance, the city received a 100% clean audit from the state auditor last year for our consistent excellence in fiscal policies, practices, and accountability. In 2020, the state instituted a new Sunshine Law Star Rating System, STARS, to monitor transparency in government by testing a local government compliance with Ohio's Sunshine Laws. We are excited to share the city's received a 4-star rating, the highest achievement in open and transparent government. Special recognition is owed to our finance director, Jonathan Hudson, and city records manager, Lori Martin, for their diligence in exceeding these state requirements. Our goal is to maintain this standard of excellence in all aspects of our local government on behalf of our community. Springboro's financial outlook for 2021 remains on solid ground despite the negative impacts COVID-19 has had on the economy. This year's budget focuses on core priorities, keeping in mind the economic uncertainties 2021 may bring due to the pandemic. These priorities include maintaining the city's operational excellence thanks to staff and all of the great services they provide in the areas of public safety, infrastructure, economic development, and the quality of life. Overall, the city's approach is cautious with respect to revenue and expenditure predictions heading into the new year. City Council approved the 2021 budget in November, and total budgeted expenses were cut by approximately 10%, not knowing how COVID-19 will affect future revenue. All 45 funds reflect a total of $63.9 million in budgeted expenditures for capital, operations, and services with a very conservative year-end projection in a total fund balance of $30.2 million. Our general fund was placed for the majority of the city's administrative, safety, service, and development expenses is estimated to carry a balance of $4.2 million with $14.4 million in budgeted expenses. With reserve balances with the recommended range of 30 to 50% of expenditures, the city is in a position to draw from those reserves if necessary before needing to generate additional revenue by raising fees or taxes. Our tax rate has not increased since 1988. Total income tax revenue held steady last year, meeting projections by year end, which is a very favorable outcome considering local economies overall. The city always budgets conservatively in the revenue side and is projecting a roughly 7% decrease in income tax revenue this year as a safety measure in light of our pandemic. With the exception of mainly income tax, the city's budget is anticipated to remain relatively flat in 2021. Notably, our water and sewer fund balances remain strong enough to continue the current rate freeze and still adequately fund operating costs for those services. We applaud our staff's efforts to keep our primary government functions at the properly funded levels and continuing to focus on providing quality public services to our residents. In capital improvements, our capital improvement program, CIP, helps us plan a budget for the city's immediate and future needs in areas such as streets, infrastructure, recreational and community development. The 2021 to 2025 program proposes a $23.2 million capital investment in our community and addresses two general areas of expenditures: the protection of existing assets such as facilities and infrastructure, and the construction of new public facilities, including information technology to improve public safety, service delivery, and quality of life for our citizens. The five-year CIP has decreased $1.5 million, or approximately 6%, from the previous year, and capital spending is down this year $2.8 million over 2020. Although the 2021 program has been reduced, mirroring the budget cuts, it will continue to support core improvements such as street resurfacing, as well as other important programs that improve our safety, welfare, and general environment. In 2020, the city completed several transportation projects, including the resurfacing of South Main Street and the addition of decorative crosswalks at all six intersections in our historic downtown, making a dramatic improvement to our South Corridor. In addition, approximately 1.2 miles of Vital Five Points and Yankee Roads were resurfaced, and work included the addition of pedestrian crossing island and bike lanes as part of the continuation of Springboro's bike and pedestrian plan. Approximately 5 miles of roadway improvements were completed in 2020, including the resurfacing of 10 neighborhood streets, and the city is proposing to resurface 21 streets during this year's resurfacing and sidewalk repair program. In addition, the city was awarded approximately $4.5 million in federal safety funding grants to complete three traffic improvement projects over the next several years to improve safety and traffic flow. The first project involves replacing existing traffic signal scopes at the nine intersections along West Central Avenue and North Main Street with radar, a more reliable technology that detects vehicles as they approach the intersection and more accurately control the signal timing. The other two projects involve a dual left turn lane along West Central Avenue approaching southbound I-75 and improvements at the Remick Boulevard intersection to include a right turn lane eastbound onto Remick. We appreciate the Warren County Transportation Improvement District's assistance in obtaining 100% of the funding for these projects. Progress continues on our broadband fiber network initiative to bring high-speed internet services to the neighborhoods throughout Springboro. The city has collaborated with the Warren County Port Authority to finance the construction costs of the infrastructure needed to bring new private internet service providers, ISPs, into the Springboro market, creating competition, innovation, and potentially lower prices in the realm of high-speed internet service for our residents and businesses. Private ISPs would lease or purchase the underground conduit from the city to run their own fiber optic lines to individual homes. This $2.4 million investment in technology infrastructure will become a valuable asset in attracting new businesses and helping existing businesses and our community prepare for the smarter, faster technologies. We see this as an excellent opportunity for our residents and economic growth within the city. We would like to recognize City Manager Chris Pizzuto, IT Director Matt Lang, Finance Director Jonathan Hudson, and the Warren County Port Authority for helping to launch this exciting project. We anticipate construction to be finished by this summer. In Parks and Recreation, Springboro now has nine beautiful parks that feature a variety of amenities, including an amphitheater, walking trails, turf fields, and brand new fitness court made possible by a grant from the National Fitness Foundation. Casey Jane Park is our newest park, featuring an extremely popular splice pad, which opened in 2019 thanks to a generous donation from Springboro's Housefield family in memory of their loved ones, Casey and Tom Housefield. This past summer, we opened Phase 2 of Casey Jane Park with two new playgrounds and an interactive musical play area. The city's financial partnership with Clear Creek Township to support the park's operations and maintenance ensures it will be a place for our residents to enjoy for many years to come. Springboro's recreational facilities also include Heatherwood Golf Course. 2020 was a landmark year for Heatherwood. Superior course conditions, amenities, and customer service has positioned Heatherwood among the most highly rated public courses in the region, exceeding market standards for a quality golfing experience. Not only did the city realize top earnings on the golf course last year by maximizing the number of rounds played in 1 year reaching over 40,000, but also we are happy to report that the city paid off the debt it has carried on Heatherwood since 1999. Pursuing opportunities to reduce interest rates since the original bonds and early payoff option resulted in a savings of $492,000. Wow. We now own the flagship of our city's many great amenities and appreciate the level of excellence that Heatherwood staff operates and maintains our golf course. We also pride ourselves in bringing the community together for events including concerts, festivals, and fireworks. It has been challenging for communities to offer these events with COVID-19 restrictions in place. However, the city took the steps necessary to make sure we could safely move forward with some of the popular programs we offer to our residents with our Concert in the Park series. The 2020 concerts were a big hit, according to many residents who attended or watched the concerts live from our website. We were able to host 7 of our 10 scheduled concerts thanks to a tremendous effort by our park board members and staff to pull all the necessary precautions in place recommended by our state and county health department to ensure everyone's health and safety was a priority. We're also glad many of you had the opportunity to get out and enjoy the concerts as well as our annual fireworks display, co-sponsored by Springboro Schools and Clear Creek Township, and other events like Bike the Borough and Borough Barbecue Fest. Thank you to our park board and staff for all the effort they put into coordinating these events for the community to enjoy this past year. In community economic development, Springboro is always open for business and continues to welcome new companies to our 500-plus business community. The city also supports economic growth by participating in regional development initiatives like Business First, an intergovernmental program focused on business retention and expansion in local jurisdictions. The program connects member communities to more than 80 source partners offering job training, low-interest business loans, and more to help our local businesses grow and extend job opportunities. These programs go hand-in-hand with our efforts to build relationships with our businesses by dedicating staff and resources to making sure the city is doing everything possible to be a partner in their success. Notwithstanding the effects of COVID-19 on the economy, approximately 132,000 square feet of business expansion and redevelopment projects were approved by our planning commission throughout the community in 2020. As the city was welcoming Fort Wayne in August, construction began on 13,000 square feet of additional commercial space at Wright Station to host a luxury nail salon, Cassano's Pizza, and several other new tenants. To date, 3 of the potential 7 commercial building sites have been construction and in development. Last year, the city received approval to establish the Dora, designated outdoor refreshment area. The Dora allows patrons to purchase alcoholic beverages from a designated Dora establishment and carry them within a defined area at Wright Station. Dora establishments include Warp Wing, Cassano's, Heroes, and the Performing Arts Center. The city plans for Wright Station to be a destination where people can enjoy food, drinks, and entertainment, and has added free Wi-Fi for people to use while enjoying the Dora and other Wright Station amenities. Costs associated with the Wi-Fi utilities were covered by CARES Act funding, and plans are to extend public Wi-Fi locations to the downtown area and city parks in the future to allow residents to work, learn, and relax remotely. Several businesses in the western portion of the city developed significant expansions in operations and warehousing, and most recently plans were approved for the redevelopment of the Kroger site along State Route 73. Kroger plans to construct a 90,000 square foot store on the Kmart portion of the site. The existing 56,000 square feet Kroger building will be reserved for new tenants. The city has also been working with Kroger over the past 2 years to rehabilitate the former Kmart location, and a new store is anticipated to open in late 2021. Most of the growth over our local economy over the past year was covered in a local feature, Spotlight on Springboro, in the Dayton Business Journal. Our Springboro Chamber of Commerce also reported adding 100 new members since the organization relocated its offices to the Performing Arts Center in 2019 and helped us cut the ribbon on at least 15 new businesses or expansions over the past year. Spotlight on Springboro has brought our city regional attention for the third consecutive year. We'd like to thank Assistant City Manager Greg Shackelford for the time and effort he has dedicated to these and other economic development programs in our community. Community leadership and service. We have many citizen community boards in our city, and we thank them for all their hard work. Those committees and council focus on specific areas of community development. We rely on the support and leadership of these committee volunteers to help us implement many special projects and programs that shape our community and are grateful for their continuing dedication and service. Board and commission highlights from 2020 include the Architectural Review Board, referred to as ARB, selection of three recipients of our annual Historic Preservation Awards. The awards program has been recognizing citizens for contributions in both historic building restoration and preservation leadership since 2000. Awards were presented to John Peeler for his long-term stewardship of 4005 South Main Street, first restored in 1972, and Charlie Schaefer for his work as a Springboro Historic Society trustee to further engage the public's interest in Springboro's rich heritage through programs and events. The ARB has also honored longtime Springboro historian Don Ross with an award for his work on public educational programs offered through the Historical Society and being among the Society's founders. In addition, the ARB has approved nearly $150,000 in historic preservation grants since the program was initiated in 2017 to help fund the restoration of our historic buildings. Supporting these preservation projects has made a positive impact over a substantial portion of the district by protecting its historic integrity and stimulating further investment in the downtown area. Springboro's Bicycle and Pedestrian Advisory Committee presented the city's bicycle and pedestrian plan to council for approval last July. Committee members work with a consultant and citizens to develop the priorities and recommendations in the second phase of the plan, including expansion of the existing bicycle and pedestrian network and more family-friendly routes and recreational options such as multi-use off-road trails. With a newly updated plan adopted, the city will be able to obtain state grants for the plan's continued implementation, beginning with the development of a multi-use trail from Clear Creek Park to Hazelwood Park. Last year, the city appointed a committee of 9 community leaders to review the city master plan, which will be used as a guide for Springboro's long-range growth, development, and redevelopment over the next 10 years. The program began last fall using a community survey to gather public input, and more than 400 residents responded to the survey. The city selected MKSK of Columbus to facilitate the review process and work with the Master Plan Committee over the next year to complete the project. Springboro's original Master Plan was developed in 1998 and revised in 2009. The plan has been an essential tool in the management of our community's development for the past 2 decades. Community safety is very important to us. It is a core service provided by the city's exceptional police force of 21 uniformed police officers, a command staff, detectives unit, and communications center that received approximately 16,000 calls for service in 2020. The Springboro Police Department, led by Chief Jeff Kreidolf, focuses on service-oriented policing and is committed to the safety and protection of our citizens. Our police department provides programs and services to help us protect our community, including crime prevention tools such as Borough Street Watch, which allows residents to register their home security cameras with the police department to aid in deferring crime, and police mobile app to provide a more convenient way to report crime and receive safety information. Our police officers also meet with residents to address questions and concerns regarding community safety. Programs like these, along with department's presence on social media, helps to foster more community-oriented safety by staying connected with our police department. Our police officers also anticipate in regional law enforcement through agencies such as the Warren County Drug Task Force and the Miami Valley Technical Crime Suspension Unit, which aid in investigations, policing, and sharing costs for specialized equipment and training. The Springboro Police Department also serves our community in the areas of school safety and community outreach that continue to make a positive impact in the community. Our department provides 2 full-time school resource officers funded in partnership with Springboro Schools and the Springboro DARE program to maintain a safe and healthy environment in our school community. In addition, our police officers sponsor the Operation Santa program, which provides holiday meals, gifts, and necessities for families with children in need in our community each December. We would like to express our gratitude to everyone in the community who has supported this program for the past 23 years. However, the newest outreach program began when Blue, I love our Blue, our police dog, our comfort dog, joined the department in 2019. Blue provides a special service to the community by visiting schools and nursing homes, attending community events, and providing comfort and reassurance to individuals experiencing a crisis or distress. Blue celebrated his first birthday in 2020. I gave him a dog bone. And he is often seen greeting people at our police department with his welcoming and calm presence. Our police department works hard to keep Springboro one of the top 10 safest rated cities in Ohio. And we thank our officers for all the great safety and welfare services they provide our community. On a final note, many thanks to our management staff, department directors, and employees for making Springboro a leader in programs and services that positively impact our businesses, schools, and our residents. We appreciate all that you have accomplished this past year and your willingness to rise to the challenge created by COVID-19. We've emerged from 2020 better prepared to respond to the uncertainty of what lies ahead in the coming year. It is an immense honor to serve this great community, and I thank all my colleagues, Deputy Mayor Jim Smill, and council members Dale Brunner, Jack Hansen, Steve Harding, Becky Iverson, and Janie Redd for their unity and teamwork. Please accept my very best wishes for your health, safety, and well-being as we welcome a new year together. Stay connected, Springboro. God bless all of you. Thank you.